As I was reading Acts chapter 10 this weekend, some words jumped out, and it was God's awareness. Wow, and I thought about that. And let's look at the setting of this. This was a man named Cornelius. He was a Roman. He was an army officer. And the scripture reports something about this man. He and his family, he was leading his family, were devout, and they respected God. He was a religious man. He gave to the poor. That's very important. God talks about that in our giving, we need to give to the poor or to the widows. And if you're watching this and you're saying, I don't know of a real good ministry that is working with the poor and really helping them. Well, I can tell you one. It's run by my son. And it's in Houston, Texas. And part of their ministry is in Uganda, Africa. And you can see that video on our website, The Uganda Man. But his ministry is called Attack Poverty, Breaking Generational Poverty. And they have adopted this ghetto. He's been working there so far for 4 years. And what they're trying to do is to help the children of people trapped in that poverty, helping to equip the children in so many different ways, and you can learn all about that from his ministry, and helping them to get out of that cycle of poverty and all of that, and to be able to get a job and be able to make it. And so many kids want out, but they don't know how to get out. Many of those kids have never been out of the ghetto ever. Never been out, never been anywhere except in that ghetto, not even across the freeway where they're kind of hemmed in. Anyway, he gave to the poor because he realized that that was very, very important. And the third thing, it says, he always prayed to God. He had a regular prayer life. This man was religious, but he had not yet become a real, true believer. There's a lot of religious people that are lost. They've never accepted Christ as their personal Savior from sin. And we have family members like that in my family that are religious, nice people, but they've never trusted Christ for salvation. Well, Cornelius was praying and he had a vision. And an angel showed up. Wow, you know, wouldn't that be wonderful to pray and have an angel show up and give you a message from God? And what was the message this angel wanted to assure Cornelius of? He said, God is aware of your prayers, your life of prayer. God is aware of your giving to the poor, and God has remembered you. And God is going to answer your prayers. To really know God. But a part of all of that, for you coming to really know God, I will use a man called Peter, and he will tell you the way to God. Now it's interesting, the angel is right there. Why didn't the angel? Because Cornelius was seeking a deeper reality, relationship with God. Why didn't the angel give him the plan of salvation? Because the plan of salvation was not committed to angels to share with men. If God had done it that way, the world had been a lot better off than committing that message to you and me. How many people have you shared that message with? The message of salvation. Have you been a tool in someone's life coming to know Christ in a very real way? So God used a man, and he used a man that was usable. See, this is God's way. Go into all the world, and as you're going, share the gospel message. See, are you and I willing to be used by God to bring the message of salvation to those who are seeking God? Cornelius was seeking God, and God was aware of that. And God was going to take a man who was willing to be used and a man he was seeking and bring them together. What does a seeker look like? Well, I can't tell you. Seekers look like anybody. Because God looks on the heart, we look on the outer appearance. Sometimes the least likely person that we look at, we have no idea that in his heart, God is preparing him for the message. Am I willing to share that message? God knows. We need that mental attitude of an Old Testament prophet. He said, "Here am I, send me." And God gave a message to Jeremiah. He was a timid guy. And from all indications, and God said, "Don't be afraid of their faces." He had to speak to people. And Jeremiah's message was not positive. It was about the judgment of God coming on a nation. And as far as we know, if I remember right, no one responded positively to his message. But why don't we just pray right now? You're watching. Why don't we pray right now? Father, we know the world is lost, and there's people all around us that are going into a crisis eternity. And there are people out there that you are aware of, that they are seeking. Some may be religious, doing certain acts and activities, but they don't have that relationship. You know who they are. We don't know who they are. Father, if someone watching this, you're speaking to their heart, we ask, Lord, your Holy Spirit would make them willing to be the person who would take the message to someone who is seeking. Lord, I pray that you would work in everyone's heart that will watch this and give them that desire. There are people out there that are trying to find reality in God, but they don't know how. And Father, there may be a neighbor, they may be someone at work, there may be someone we pass every day, it may be a clerk in the store. You know who they are. And Lord, help us to be willing to be used, like Peter was. you used Peter, who was a distance away from where Cornelius was, to help this man and his family come to a real personal relationship with you. May we be like Peter. May we be someone who is willing to be used in the spreading of your message in your kingdom, and that you would be glorified, Father. Amen.